thing that holds onto our larynx.
Thyroid apparatus.
Thyroid apparatus and what's its function?
Holds it. Protects the larynx.
It protects the larynx, right, and it also assists in?
Swallowing.
Swallowing, very important for swallowing, okay?
What kind of cartilage is where?
Yeah, okay. What's the difference between three types of cartilage? What are the three types of cartilage?
Hyaline.
Hyaline?
And.
Fibrocartilage?
Elastic.
Elastic cartilage, very good. Okay, where do we find elastic cartilage?
Elastic.
It's in your ears, it's in your pinna. It's what allows you to do this, okay? How about fibrocartilage?
In your nose.
She's got it. Yeah, it's in your nose too.
Is that like what comes with the sound of the wind and stuff?
Fibrocartilage?
Yeah.
Fibrocartilage, where do we find that? In my cycle it's there, but not in normal cycles, okay? Fibrocartilage is going to be in, actually it is, it's in the midst of, okay? So yes, it would be. It's also going to be in your intervertebral discs, and it's also going to be in any area that has hyaline cartilage has gotten damaged. So that's what replaces hyaline cartilage, right? Okay, how about hyaline cartilage itself? We didn't discuss that yet.
Yeah,
it's in your growth plate, right, if you're a baby. And how about if you're an adult, is it in there too?
No.
Okay, so where else would we find hyaline cartilage?
Isn't that what with the ears when they calcify into,
nope.
Being upset?
That's elastic cartilage.
Okay.
So it's elastic cartilage and that can calcify. Any cartilage can calcify.
Okay.
Okay. All it requires for cartilage to calcify is blood supply. Okay, so if you damage something, you get a blood supply in there, and it can cause calcification. Okay? Now, you said joints, and that is correct. What kind of joint?
Diaphoresis
joint. Very good. Okay, and so that's a really important thing, because what's the characteristic of hyaline cartilage that makes it good in the joints?
It's slippery.
It's slippery, and it contains a lot of... Does it have a whole lot of fibers in it?
No.
It's mostly fluid, right? So when we have the joint capsules moving around and we're putting weight-bearing stuff on it, what happens is that pumps that hyaline cartilage full of water, okay? And that keeps it healthy, all right? So that's a really important thing, okay? Good. What are the characteristics of the connective tissue? Okay, that is a function of...
You mean like within it? Like collagen, elastin,
Well, if I say a characteristic of a connective tissue, that's going to cover all the different types of connective tissues that are there, right? So what are three things that every connective tissue has? Fibers. Matrix. Cells. Right. Because not every connective tissue has fibroblasts, right? Okay, does blood have fibroblasts?
Okay.
Okay? So, you know, we've got to remember that blood is a connective tissue, right? So we always have to remember that. Okay?
You said bone is a connective tissue.
Bone is a connective tissue. Yeah, so what is the matrix for bone? So what's the matrix for bone? Marrow's not so much matrix. Marrow's contained within it. But what's the matrix of the bone? What is the matrix?
Nucleus.
No. So if we have a connective tissue, like loose areolar connective tissue, the matrix is going to be that that interstitial stuff that's holding the collagen fibers in place. Does that make sense? Okay. In blood, our matrix would be the plasma, right? Okay. In bone, we've got the matrix is basically it's hydroxyapatite crystals. Okay. It's just what's contained within it. We've got fibers. What is the fibers for bone and for loose areolar and dense regular connective tissue?
Collagen.
Correct. Okay. If we have stretchy material, what are the fibers in that one?
Elastin.
Right. And there's that other weird little fiber that we have. What is that called?
Keratin.
No, keratin's in your skin. That's a completely different thing. That's a protein that's contained within cells. Okay. So it's something called reticulin. Okay. So that was the third type of fiber that we have to consider. Okay. How about cells? What kind of cells live in the bone?
Osteoblasts
and osteocytes, right? Okay. And how about cartilage? Not so much. There are some in the fibrocartilage, but most of it is another type of cell. No, hematopoiesis just means blood making.
Are there cells called something like that?
Hematopoietic cells? Yeah.
Okay,
they're in the bone marrow. How about chondrocytes, right? Chondrocytes are cartilage cells, okay? And, you know, so those are the types of things you should think about. On your bone marrow, okay, so we've got baby blood cells. That's what hematopoiesis means, okay? It's just brand new blood cells, all right? About when does that stop being red bone marrow in kids? About puberty, right? Okay? And what does it get replaced by? Right, yellow marrow. So the two functions of bone marrow are what?
Fat storage and blood.
Fat storage and blood production, right? Good. Okay, so fat storage, why would that be important?
Store energy.
Yeah, stores energy. How come? Like, how much energy does fat have? It's a lot. Okay, it's about 2.5. It's 2.5. Kilocalories per gram, okay, which is about 2.5 times what carbohydrates or proteins are. Okay? So it's a lot of potential energy stored in fat. You guys okay? Alright. So those are the types of things to think about. What are the four types of passive transport and what are they?
Simple diffusion.
Filtration.
Osmosis.
Yes.
And
facilitated.
Oh, that's the
one. Yeah. Okay, good. All right, so what's the definition of osmosis?
Isn't that when water
goes through water? Water goes
from
something.
From a higher concentration to
a
lower
concentration.
That's all right. So it's close. Right, it has to go through a membrane. So that's the one where the blood cells explode in, mm-hmm. Right? So think if it makes it easier for you, just describe the way it moved with the blood cell.
Okay?
Because some people see better with that picture in their head. Okay? How about facilitated diffusion?
Not the one where it has to have a receptor?
Yes.
It has to bond to a receptor.
It has to bond to a receptor. Get pulled in, right?
Yeah.
So what kind of protein would that be?
Transport
protein. That's the lava lamp, right?
Oh, okay,
protein is the lava lamp. Okay. So that's facilitated